Now let us consider moving coil galvanometer, MCG. It is also an arrangement or instrument to measure current. What are the current passing through the circuit that can be measured? This works on the principle of couple acting on the rectangular coil. We know that whenever a rectangular coil is placed in a uniform magnetic field, imagine a coil is suspended, a freely suspended magnet, a current carrying coil. So whenever it is placed, it experiences a couple given by C is equal to M B cos theta or B I N A cos theta. And couple is maximum when theta is equal to 0, that is plane is parallel to the field. Couple is 0 when the plane is perpendicular to the field. So by measuring the twist through which the coil is rotating, because of the magnetic field, coil starts rotating. If you know the deflection, by measuring the deflection, it is possible to calculate what is the current passing through each. When the plane is parallel, couple is maximum. When plane is perpendicular, couple is zero. For any amount of current, whether it is 0.1 ampere or 3.2 ampere or 0.01 ampere, whatever you take, irrespective of the value of the current, initially couple is maximum when the plane is perpendicular, finally it rotates and comes to rest. If current is more, couple is more, very fast it will come to rest perpendicular to the field. If the current is less, slowly it comes to rest perpendicular to the field. So the purpose of calculating current is not possible if I take this arrangement. Let us concentrate on the point maximum couple when theta is equal to 0 degree. C is BINA. So always see that the plane of the coil will be parallel to the field. So this can be achieved using a concave shaped magnetic poles. Here the magnetic field is produced using concave shaped magnetic poles. NS. We know that lines of force always perpendicular to the pole, the line of force starts from north pole to south pole, they move. So let us say the line of force like this. These are magnetic lines of force. This field is called radial magnetic field. Instead of straight this kind of field, I am taking a radial magnetic field. The purpose of the radial magnetic field is such that always the plane of the coil will be parallel to the field direction. So irrespective of the orientation, even after rotation, the plane of the coil at any position will be parallel to some field direction. Once we say plane is parallel, then automatically C becomes equal to BINA. Now if coupled required to produce unit twist in the suspended wire, because the rectangular coil is connected or suspended using a wire, let us suppose C is the coupled required to produce unit twist. Because of the passage of current, let the twist be theta, then restoring couple is called C theta. Here C is coupled required to produce unit twist in the wire. This is called restoring couple for theta twist. Then restoring couple and applied couple are equal, then coil will remain at rest at that angle, because once the current is passing, coil starts rotating. After rotating certain angle, it will come to rest. The reason for coming rest is, this is the applied couple, this is the restoring couple, this is the couple developed in the wire or thread. So if these two are equal, then it comes to rest. Then using this equation, I is equal to C by BAN into theta, we can measure the current passing through the circuit. So if I take the practical arrangement, this is the case. This is the radial magnetic field. See, the concave shaped poles, they are producing field like this. Even in this position, the magnetic lines of force will be parallel. Actually, these magnetic poles structure will appear like this. and in between that this current carrying coil is suspended using a thread. Now this is the actual case. These are all lines of force, north pole, south pole. For the wire, you can connect a needle and connect it to the scale. By knowing the rotation or angle through which it turns, it is possible to calculate. So irrespective of the orientation of the coil, because of the radial field, whether the magnetic is like this or even like this or even the coil is like this, the field is always parallel. We can see from this figure also, if I keep the coil like this, parallel, even if the coil comes like this, parallel, even if the coil is like this, parallel to the field. So couple always on it is maximum. The purpose of the couple is to produce turning effect. Because of this, coil starts rotating. Once the coil starts rotating, this wire, in the suspended wire, a twist is produced. Suppose this wire is already tested for unit twist. To produce unit twist in the wire, let us say couple required is a C. Now because of the current passing through the coils, let us say couple produced is a C theta, angular displacement or a twist. So restoring couple in the wire, this is called a C theta. But acting couple, due to the passage of the current in the coil and place in the magnetic field, the acting couple is B I N A. Since always the plane of the coil is parallel to the field direction, when these two are equal, then only it comes to rest. Otherwise, coil rotates. See, as I increases, automatically acting couple increases, so theta restoring couple also increases. So at any instant, I proportional to theta. So normally in old days, lamp and scale arrangement is used to measure theta. Lamp and scale arrangement. But now directly by connecting a needle, see, for this string, directly from the string a needle is connected and you can measure the deflection. So by measuring the deflection, we can estimate what is the current passing through it, since I is proportional to theta. So here the important points is the produced magnetic field. It is a radial field. The purpose of the radial field is always the field is couple acting on the coil is maximum and plane of the coil will be parallel to the field direction. Due to this reason only, C is always BINA. And for that, north and south poles are concave shaped magnetic, north and south poles are used. Now generally the wire used to suspend the coil, this wire must have certain qualities. Number one, elongation must be very very small. Suppose if it elongates because of the weight of this one, here we are suspending a load, current carrying coil is a load. Because of this, suppose if the wire elongates, so this coil moves down, that means it moves away from the field. So it should not have much elongation. E must be small. Elongation must be small. We know that Y is equal to FL by A. Once we say E is small, then Y must be large. Young's modulus must be very high for the material. Second case, twist, easily twisting wire. If the twisting is very easy, even small currents can also be measured. We know that twisting is measured with respect to eta, n. This is stress by strain, F by A by theta. Theta must be large, very small currents must produce a large twist. When I say theta is more, then rigidity modulus must be less, n or eta. So the wire used to suspend the coil must have high Young's modulus and small rigidity modulus. So because of this reason, normally used wires are quartz wires are used to suspend the coils, because quartz has high Young's modulus, small rigidity modulus. Or second one, phosphor bronze. This also satisfies these two conditions, high Young's modulus and small rigidity modulus. So phosphor branch or quartz are used to suspend the coil. And finally, in tangent galvanometer, we know that I proportional to tan theta. But in moving coil galvanometer, I proportional to theta.